This is the day that the Lord hath made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Praise the Lord, everyone. This morning we welcome you to our services. My husband, Bishop L.G. Thomas, and I would like to welcome all of our saints, our friends, everywhere in the mighty name of Jesus. God is still on the throne, and he's still doing his job. He's still in control. No matter what is happening in the world today with this pandemic crisis, God is in control. And this morning, we are standing on the promises of Christ our God. He will never leave us, and he will never forsake us. So right now, stop what you're doing. Sit back, relax, and listen to what we have to offer you from Faith Chapel Ministries. We hope that your heart will be blessed and you will be encouraged to continue worshiping and serving God, because there is no other way. God bless you all. Amen. Lord Jesus, we long to be perfectly whole. We want you forever to live in our soul. Cast out every idol, cast out every foe, and wash us, and we shall be whiter than snow. This morning, Lord, as we come before your presence, we praise you, we adore you, we magnify you, and we lift you up. You are the King of Kings. You are the Lord of Lords. You are the everlasting Father, and you are the Prince of Peace. This morning, God, as we come before your presence, we ask you to forgive us of all our unrighteousness. We come before you as filthy rags, but we know with your power, with your grace, and with your might, you will forgive us. And so we're asking you to forgive us and to help us that we can come to you and just worship you in the beauty of holiness. We thank you for keeping us through the week. So many people, Lord, started out the week, but they have not been able to see the end thereof. Hallelujah! But Father, we thank you for taking us through the week. We thank you for your hand of protection. We thank you for your love, and we thank you for this opportunity that we can come before you boldly this morning and proclaim your name. We thank you that you will be in the service this morning. We thank you for the scriptures that will be read. We thank you for the songs that will be sung. We thank you for the message that will go forth with anointing, with clarity, so that souls will be saved. We thank you, Lord Jesus, that you're a God who cares and understands about each and every one of us this morning. And so this morning, if there's someone who does not know you in the pardon of their sin, when the word goes forth, we ask, Lord Jesus, that your power will so illuminate the heart of your people that they will be saved. Somebody who is sick, we ask that your word will touch. Somebody who is discouraged, somebody who is afraid, somebody who needs peace, your word will come forth and illuminate that soul, illuminate that heart, and make them see, realize, and understand that God is a God of God, and that you're the only one who can help us in this time and day. Indeed, in times like these, we need a savior. Glory. We need an anchor. But we have you, the everlasting Father, who will not fail. You will come forth and you will help us in the time of need. So we're asking you right now, O God, that you'll just have mercy upon us, that you'll help us as a people, help us as a church, help us as a nation, help us as a world. O God, we need you more than the very breath that we're breathing. And we ask that you'll take full control this morning as we give ourselves to you. Holy Spirit, take full control of the service and have your will be done, we pray. And at the end of the day, we will not forget to give you the praise. We will not forget to give you the honor. We will not forget to give you the glory, because you are worthy. You are worthy. You are worthy. Worthy is the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world. Christ the King of Kings, let his banner be unfurled. Have your will be done now, we pray, Lord Jesus, as we look to you. In Jesus' name, we have the victory. Amen.
Today's lesson is taken from Ephesians chapter 4, and I'll be reading from verse 1 through to verse 6. I, therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, beseech you that you walk worthy of the vocation wherewith you are called, with all lowliness and meekness, with long-suffering, forbearing one another in love, endeavouring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, even as ye are called in one hope of your calling. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all, and through all, and in you all. Apostle Paul wrote this letter to the saints who were at Ephesus, the Ephesian saints, and in the first three chapters, he told them a lot about all the things that Christ had done for them, all the things that God had done for them through Christ. And we can apply those same things to our lives, because when we have accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as our personal Saviour and become a part of the family of God, then this applies to us also. When it comes to chapter 4 through to 6, Apostle Paul is saying, now on the basis of what you've learned that God has done for you through Christ, now this is how you ought to be, or these are the things you ought to do. And they're really practical steps for walking with God. And when you look at what he told them in chapters 1 through to 3, how, and as we said, we're applying it today, how God has accepted us in the well-beloved. He's redeemed us. He has forgiven our sins. He's made us known the mystery of his will. He's made us heirs and joint heirs with Christ. He's sealed us to the day of redemption. He's made us alive together in Christ. He's seated us together with him in heavenly places in Christ Jesus, and many other things. So he said, now, therefore, as a result of that, then here's what you need to do. Walk worthy of the vocation wherewith you are called, or walk worthy of your calling. So when we speak about walking worthy, what are we really saying? We're talking about walking in a manner that is befitting of the call, that is best suited to the call, that fully reflects the call, or that is conducive of the call of God on our lives. And Apostle Paul doesn't just leave it there. He tells them how this will look, the characteristics of walking worthy. He said, you know, it's with all meekness and gentleness. When he's speaking there, he's talking about with humility, walking with humility. When you look at how Paul described himself, even with the great Damascus Road experience that he had, he still described himself as being the least of the apostles and not even being worthy to be called an apostle. That was his humility. He then said, you know, he referred to himself as the least of all the saints. That was humility speaking. In the Greek culture, humility wasn't a considered a virtue. It wasn't something to be proud about. However, in Christianity, humility is a virtue. Philippians 2 verses 1 through to 10 lets us know that with all lowliness of heart, we should esteem others better than ourselves. We should prefer others before ourselves. So when we speak about humility, it's not pushing your own agenda. It's preferring others better than yourself. Gentleness, being caring, being kindly affectioned one towards another. When you look at it, meekness or gentleness, it's that same Greek word which is used for taming an animal. So it's the great force of the animal, and you've now brought it subject to that of the trainer or the master. You have the ability, or you have the capacity to flaunt yourself, but you don't do that. You're humble. You've been brought under, or you bring yourself under to prefer others better than yourself. Long-suffering, it's that spirit which never gives up. It never concedes defeat. But it also is that spirit which is patient with men. It's that spirit that has the power to take revenge, but never does. Long-suffering. In this time more than ever, we ought to be long-suffering with one another. Not ready to lash out, not ready to retaliate, not ready to be easily offended by everything and want to put people in their place. Suffer long. He said, forbearing one another, or bearing with each other in love. When you look, the love of God, the agape love, the love which loves the unlovable and loves expecting nothing in return. 1 Corinthians 13 and verse 7 tells us that that love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Some of the times we are not willing to bear much. All right, you may say something that I don't like once and I let you off once, but dare you do it the second time. But Apostle Paul is saying to walk worthy of the call of God on our lives, we ought to bear with one another in love, recognizing that God loved us and has borne a whole lot with us. Then endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. The unity of the Spirit, we didn't create it, it was given to us. When we receive the Spirit of God, we were united in one. And he says, just recognize that we are now one through the Spirit and keep that unity. How do we do that? Stay tuned in with God. When we're tuned in to the Spirit, we will always sense what is God's agenda, and our agenda takes second place. Our agenda is not to be seen. We're all to be on God's agenda. When we stay connected to God through the Spirit, we will all promote the kingdom agenda. And the kingdom agenda is that God be glorified and that souls be saved. I firmly believe that in this time of lockdown and self-isolation, there's a great harvest of souls to be had. There are many who will turn to God, but we will only be on God's agenda when we remain united in the Spirit. God bless you. Let us walk worthy of the vocation wherewith we are called. The Lord bless you.
Wherever you are, just worship, just worship, just worship. Give God thanks. Give him honor, give him glory. Hallelujah, give him praise. Lord, we come with our hearts wide open. Lord, we know you have made us. Lord, we are waiting, anticipating. We are creating a place for you. Lord, we come with our
see a move of God.
Special time like these.
Christian greetings to all our saints today in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Thank God for this privilege that we can speak to each other in your home and to give worship and praise as we do in the church. I trust that everyone is keeping well, everyone is taking care of themselves as we get the order from the government that we have got to secure ourselves, amen, naturally. So I just hope that everyone is doing as they're asked to do from the government. Today, as we come together in our service, we want to look at the word of the Lord, which two verses of scripture I want to deal with. One is coming from Galatians chapter 5, verse 1, and also from St. John 6, verse 68. In Galatians chapter 5, verse 1, stand fast, therefore, in the liberty wherewith Christ hath made us free, and be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage. And in St. John 60, verse 68, then Simon Peter answered him, "Lord, to whom shall we go? Thou hast the word of eternal life." Let us pray. Father, we come in the name of Lord Jesus, and we come with worship today. We come with praise. We come in adoration, and we come with thanksgiving. The word of Jude, writing to the saints, amen, said, "Saints who were sanctified by God the Father, preserving Jesus Christ and call, mercy unto you, peace and love be multiplied." I pray today that the peace and the love of God will multiply and increase, amen, among the saints as we continue to put our trust in you and to give thanks for the things that you have done. You have done great things. You have blessed us with all spiritual blessing, and you have caused us to be together in heavenly places in Christ. Today in our home, we are in heavenly places because your presence is with us, and we thank you in Jesus' name. As we look at the scriptures in Galatians chapter 5, verse 1, we'll see where the saints were going back into the law, and the Apostle Paul was reminding them that who have bewildered them, that they have gone back from the truth. And so whatever is happening, let us remain, amen, in the truth. Let us remain with the word of God. And when we come to St. John chapter 6 and verse 68, we see where Jesus had 82 disciples. And when he said unto them, "Unless you eat of my flesh and drink of my blood, you have no life." And then many of them turned back. 70 of them turned back. And Jesus turned to the 12 and said, "Will ye also go?" And then Peter said, "To whom shall we go? Thou hast the word of eternal life." And so today we're here in the service because of the life that has been given by the Lord Jesus. And we acknowledge the word of God. Amen. We acknowledge the life that comes through the word of the Lord. And that is why we continue to give worship. We continue to give praise and to exalt the name of the Lord. Our message today, stand regardless. Stand regardless. 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 3. "Watch ye, stand fast in faith, quit yourself like men, and be sober." In 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8, "Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walking about, seeking whom he may devour." The church is called upon to stand fast in this, in the liberty, amen, wherewith the Lord has given us. Amen. We must not be entangled again with the yoke of bondage, amen, knowing that the enemy is waiting to bring us back into captivity. Standing defined as permanent, fixed, lasting. The word of God is fixed and lasting. We are called to stand firm in faith, believing. We have the record of the saints who have gone on before, how they suffered in manifold temptation. In their suffering, they remained faithful. All of us, as members of the body of Christ, must stand together in faith, knowing that God loves us. Therefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, and be he, that he may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girded about with truth, and your having on the breastplate of righteousness. Whatever is happening, let us make sure that we are standing with everything that is right. We must stand with the gospel of peace, with the shield of faith, and with the helmet of salvation. With the word of God, which is the sword of the Spirit, having the whole armor of God to withstand, even with confidence. Storms and cares of life will come and go, but we will still stand, trusting, believing the word of God. In 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 17, the word of the Lord came to Jehoshaphat after he was faced with three nations against him in battle. The Lord said, he shall not need to fight in the battle. Set yourselves, stand ye still, and see the salvation of the Lord. We are standing with the grace of God that brought salvation. Salvation gives us the privilege to stand with the promises of God. We are standing with spiritual assurances. We are standing in faith, believing our Redeemer and our Deliverer, the Lord Jesus Christ. Stand without fear. The Almighty God of heaven, He is our helper. He has helped us in many ways, and we have proven the help of God. Amen. He has blessed us with all spiritual blessing, and He has caused us to be together in heavenly places. And so the psalmist said, oh, that men would praise the Lord for His goodness and for His wonderful work toward the children of men. Amen. We were born in sin, shaped in iniquity, but the Lord Jesus Christ, amen, has laid on His life, amen, that we may be raised up. And so the Apostle Paul reminds us, amen, in Ephesians chapter 2, you are to be quickened who are dead in trespasses and sins. Now we receive the life of Jesus. Jesus said, unless we eat of His flesh and drink of His blood, we have no life. Amen. We have eaten the flesh and the blood of Jesus. Amen. As we take our communion by faith, we receive the life of Jesus. And so today, amen, as we are coming together on social media, let us still hold on to the faith that we receive from the word of the Lord. Amen. Faith that will take us through. Amen. In this time that we are going through, faith is the substance of things hoped for. We have not seen the end. Amen. But the end will come to an end. Amen. We know that our God is our helper, and He will help us that and that right early. Let us continue to trust God. Let us continue to be faithful. Let us continue to read His word. Let us continue to be supported by the Holy Spirit that is with us. Amen. The Spirit of the Lord, remember the Spirit of God is with you. Wherever you are in your house, the Spirit of God is there because you are born by the word. Amen. And you have received the Spirit of the Lord. And so today we can have confidence. Amen. And we can believe that God is with us. Amen. Whatever we're doing, the Bible said, when two or three are gathered together, touching anything concerning His name, He is in the midst. And if He is in the midst, then of course we know that the blessing of God is with us. Be faithful. Amen. Remain in the will of God. Remain, amen, in the love of God. Amen. Continue to trust God and to believe Him, knowing that, amen, He is a deliverer and He will deliver us, and that right early. May the Lord be with you today. May the blessing of God be with us as we continue to look unto Him from whence cometh our help. We know that He will help. He will help. Amen. In the time of trouble. We are not in trouble. Amen. We are not in trouble. If we get in trouble, we know that the Lord will help us, because that is His word. Amen. He's a present help in time of trouble. So we're trusting Him today, and we're just looking unto Him. Amen. Be faithful and keep well in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord, everyone. So glad that you could join us today for our online worship service. Trust that you have been blessed by the word of God. Truly, his word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path in these dark, uncertain times. We give God thanks today that we have been able to connect in spirit from our various locations. Because if ever a time we need the Lord, surely we need him now. If there's ever a time we need to be closer drawn to God, surely it is now. Anyone listening today and need the Lord or need prayer, we are here for you and invite you to visit our website, www.faithchapel.org.uk, and submit your requests. Let us close in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for our time of worship, praise, and your word. Lord, we thank you for our lives and pray that you will continue to watch over us and cover us with your blood. We thank you that in these uncertain times, you have not given us the spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and a sound mind. Oh God, please keep our minds sound, a mind that is stayed on thee. Help us, O Lord, to come in agreement with your word, that you are our refuge and strength, and you are our present help in times of trouble. Help us, O Lord, to realize that no evil shall befall us, neither shall any plague come nigh our dwelling, and you will satisfy us with long life. We thank you, Lord, that you have given your angels charge over us, and you have covered us with your feathers. Help us, O Lord, to abide under your wings. Help us, O God, to take you at your word, which say, we will call upon you and you will answer. So I pray today that you will stretch your healing hands to any of our brothers and sisters that have been affected by this rampant pandemic. And we ask in the name of Jesus that you, O God, will heal our land. The locusts and the plague is devouring the world, but we come against it in the name of Jesus. O God, we are endeavoring to humble ourselves and pray and seek your face, so you, O God, will hear from heaven. You'll forgive our sins and you will heal our land. Lord, I pray for anyone who have lost loved ones through this virus. God, grant peace and comfort to those left behind. Bless everyone today in the sound of my voice and all our Faith Chapel family. Oh God, keep us safe. Bless our pastor and his wife, the media team that has given their time to enable us to connect in this manner. We ask again, O God, that you will watch over all of us as we continue to trust thee. We pray for the government. We pray in the name of Jesus that you will help them, O God, to realize that you alone are the answer. Help them, O God, to depend on you. Help them to find some time just to seek your face. Help them, Lord, not to lean on their own understanding, but to know that there is a supreme God. There is one who has the answer. Oh, Father God, I put the government of England before you at this time, and I pray, Lord, you will give them insight. Bless every one of us today, Lord. Take our week, O God, in control. Be with each and every one of us as we continue to seek your face, as we continue to trust you, as we continue to depend on you. Bless us, Lord. Keep us, Lord Jesus, in your will, and keep us, Lord, in your way. Let us, Lord, not wander from you, but our hearts and our minds will be stayed on you, that we will be kept in perfect peace. Thank you again, Lord, and we bless your name forever and ever, and say amen in Jesus' name.